Yeah. Welcome, guys. I just see two people. So I said, look, we make you reach 100. Before I look up, we don't enter 160. Oh, wow. Bird eye view, don't they grow, my people? Now, welcome. I want to thank you for your support. Now, today be like 1 year where I start one bird eye view because yesterday, the anniversary of the beginning of NSAS, and at that time I do the first home sessions. We come turn to bird eye view. So this is like our 1 year anniversary, and I wear this special shirt. That's here. Struggle now. Available soon on shonkuti.net. Two vex paper. That wow, you able to do business. I give you number. You come out. I bet you default by hand. You default by hand. Two vex. You default by hand. You know. So in case many of you don't know, very soon I go start. I go release one film where I did do. So I've been there like almost three weeks for Ireland. They shoot this movie. Now, Nassim dusting powder for my neck like baby. 1 week of living or 2 weeks of living on the island, all my neck like this. Oh my God. I don't know whether not the water or the breeze of that island or something. Something is happening there. Oh my neck, heat rash. And AC every night. Yet I can't get heat rash. How? Now wow. Now wow. Anyway, that's my complaint of the day. Personal complaints. But let's jump right into this our discussion for the day. So that I'll figure to prepare for my event today. Today na pre-celebration dinner for CCX with the Kofo Abayomi for Victoria Island. So any of now we won't come for this event, I beg. And why all the water for Lekki brown? Why all the water for Lekki brown like this? What's going on? Anyway, my people, I don't yab wish. Make a face which I want to look. I want quick ready for this event today. May I feel push on from there. So yeah, I think who is to blame? Are they asking, you know, because many times who would they give analysis, you understand? Many times who would they give analysis about Nigeria for my radio show if I they talk and I talk about Western interests. Somebody will always call in or say things like, Sheung, don't blame the West. We don't get independence. It's the West's fault. You know, sometimes when they give analysis and they blame our leaders, people go calling. They go say, why they blame the leaders? Nigerian people deserve the leaders. Where they get? Should be the leaders gone are from the people they come. You don't understand? Then also, sometimes when I talk, say, na the people, some people will still reply, say, na the government, and things like that. So, in general, which I won't talk. There's enough blame to go around. There is enough blame to go around. You don't understand the issue we go through for Nigeria, which will they what thing happen to us, not be issue of just one group, one class. Everybody involved in Africa, everything, all of us get our blame. You understand? The blame no day somebody had exclusively. There's enough. But at the same time, the gravity of the blame is also different. Because man, if you go police station, if you get breaking and entry case, it's different from if me I get murder case. You don't understand? If you will get breaking and entry, yes, and a murder carry me come. Silence, you go do it, you go shock me. You say, thank God, oh, say, now only breaking our entry. Oh. You know, understand? So, gravity day at the same time. So, let me start from the people. You know, waiting the people they do wrong. The only thing the people they do wrong be say the people they allow other people to decide for them, within their reality be. The people no one think on their own. The people no one organize. Yes, that's the thing. The people no one organize. They no one put energy towards their own liberation. The people believe say somebody is coming to liberate them. You know, and I feel that not really the issue where the people get. Those are the blame we are always give Nigerian people. You know, we get this tendency of seeking from our oppressors our freedom. You know, we don't watch American film, we don't listen to American people. So they think, since Americans every day they always demand for their, you know, when you see Europeans protesting, they are demanding from their government. We just say it is appropriate behavior, but not the appropriate behavior for we as African people in engaging with this our tyrannical government. You understand? We know if they demand, see, we know if they ask, they beg them to recognize us. You understand? Our brothers for the West, they do that one because they are under direct white supremacy. White man did their front, they lock them out, so they beg. But we now. So if now we day here, I won't come take the beg for which is supposed to be our own. We will not send our own in the first place. So the blame of the people, you know, for me, they're very, very limited in that aspect. And now the people, they divided into two groups. You know, the working class, poor people, and the professionals, and the upper middle class, elite professionals of Lagos, you know. And it brings me into this misconception, what would they get? You know, this misconception, what would they get? So I did carry my daughter go school, you know. And, you know, early morning rush, all parents won't drop their children. So the school formed, you know, traffic queue. You know, so everybody go, you go drop your pikin, then you drive off, you go. So the earlier you come, the sooner you can leave. Right? So 90% of the parents, which are the top, 90 too small. 97% of the parents for my school, for this my daughter's school, they queue. You understand? 97% of them will queue for this queue. But like 3% go cut the queue. You understand? This 3%, they are children inside cow. This thing has since the thing where every time I see it, it bother my soul. Because I realize, say, that situation now really, you know, one moment where they encapsulate everything where they wrong with this country. This 3%, 4% of parents will not even care about their pikin then. You understand me? Their children, they inside car. They no care, say their children, they inside car. The way they no go ever care if they be leader about what they happen to their people, of the people where they supposed to lead. You understand? Those kind of people, when they become president or minister or governor or any kind of public service or even oga for private company, all these kind of people, you understand? Even to help the people they're supposed to help, no go matter to them. See, they have their children in the car. Their children, your children are everything where you're supposed to be. Your own flaws, the thing will make you be a year person, the thing where you feel say you're incomplete, you are supposed to be make sure that your child is better than you. You understand? We must make sure what. But these people, they're inside car, their children, they don't care. See, their children inside car, they won't cut queue. What did I want to teach the pikin? How is the pikin seeing life? All these things don't enter this parent head. Now, because of these 3-4% of parents, when they that front decided to took head, it they delay the rest of us when they try to move forward in the right way. Now, whose duty is it to tell those people to stop that thing? Now, the duty of the school authorities. But the school authorities, they will look away. Now, one day, I reach in front of the school. I tell the people, say, see this thing they are put for you when I do, like, say, not be anything. We where they kill will not be mumu. Me where they for line, I not be mumu. If this thing continue, any day I come drop a pikin for here, I go scatter this whole setting for this school. I no go agree make it happen. I go take laws into my hand. I no go agree. Anybody who want to, we self get where to go now. Oh God, that's why I can't drop my pikin early. You understand? You see, these people, they start to spoil the system. The authorities, now they empower them to spoil the system. I don't want to take this scenario where I give Nana, I mean, I hold on for left hand. Me, okay. Or I want to be lefty, I'm going to hold on for right hand. Never take and chop bread this morning. I'll give you another scenario where even they larger. You see me, I hate rush hour traffic. You know, I feel say that early morning traffic will be experience for Nigeria, for Lagos especially. It's an abuse of human rights. Because it show really, say, there's no wealth distribution in this country. Everybody every day is going to work for one group of people. From mainland, everybody go see, the majority of us from mainland, they pack ourselves to go only one area, go work. Coming back, there's no traffic. Because those people, we don't get any wealth from mainland, where those people with the island need to come get. Now we must always go. So everybody, every morning, you wake up at 4, 5 hours to go, then you close, 5 hours to come back. You know if you see your pikin, you know if you see your, you and your wife can't be really even be in love. You know if you, anyway. No, I cannot divert my topic. Because that's going to scatter my brain. You know. But you understand this rush hour traffic, so I avoid them. If I get things to do for island early in the morning the next day, early morning, I did light sleep for island the day before. You understand? I did light sleep for island the day before. So that the morning where I won't go do that, my business or meeting or anything, recording, I'm not gonna face that rush hour. That all traffic, all express go block. You understand me? But like 4 days ago, I had to experience this traffic because the work I won't go do, they tell me late. You understand? And I had to be there to go and do this job. So I had to face this traffic. Then I realized, say really, the traffic for no day, even though say some people go leave road. They go leave the normal road where everybody is supposed to take. Majority of Nigerians are on the normal road. Many of us are just sitting, doing what we are supposed to do, going to our, being normal, progressive human beings, thinking about everybody's progress. But we all get where they go. Important, where everybody they go, important to everybody. Majority of Nigerians sit down and they are facing the traffic, they are going. But some Nigerians, only that maybe 5-6%, they go leave the road, they will go past one kind of place, blah, 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 blah. One can go cut everybody for front to enter Roma Road back. Now, for this place, especially for that Third Mainland Bridge, one road they go, that bridge they go Yaba. You understand? One side they go Yaba, and then, you know, the other three lanes going to the island. Normally, if you know they go Yaba, you're not supposed to go enter those other two lanes. If you enter those two lanes, you're supposed to go your road straight to Yaba. But these people, they'll go follow that place, me, come go cut, enter back for front. They'll cut, enter back. Police, more than 4 police van, LASMA van, more than 5 LASMA, they there, 4 LASMA. All of them, they there. They still really look the people. So you go away, come do the right thing. You go, they feel like mumu. You go, they feel like say you no get sense. Say ah, she have the mumu ni. Why I no feel? Why me I no go do like these people? She don't understand the points what they try to make with this issue. Where they go to. This is how the system enables people where they. Oppress people where they do the negative things, like the system they do a thing, like the system they elevate, like the system they reward. So when people say Nigerian people not get power for this situation, power has a lot to do, you understand, with bringing about change. Until the people of Nigeria can organize themselves into a powerful force, a powerful political force, they no go ever fit affect or make any effect into this system. You understand? So now for me, now one of the things where I always say to people when they say, oh, Nigerian people get the government they deserve. No. Nigerian people know they feel reward anything. We have no power to reward, no, we don't get incentive to give. You understand? So when these bad people take this one way now, or this wrong road, where police supposed to immediately tell them to they go yaba. Tell them to they go yaba. The police go there, they look. If police go even act and to go there, go collect money, they go let everybody they enter after they don't do the wrong thing. So you see, the reasons why Nigerians they like this now because of say the system they reward negative behavior. The system they reward corruption. The system they reward people when they do mago-mago, cheating, lying. All these things are rewarded. All these things are rewarded. And these people, they don't care about anybody else except where they go, Abi. So, if the majority of Nigerian people, they follow the normal way, and only a few Nigerian people, they crease like this, they will now know that the problem really, we say Nigerian people just know the degree, organize themselves, take their problem seriously. Now, they are blamed there. Because many Nigerian people, women I see, are trying their best to make the country, you know, to be good citizens. If not, Nigeria will be worse than this. So I understand the blame we are giving on the people. The blame where are they put for the people front, not be say they be evil. Not people say they're complacent. That's just because they refuse to define their own reality. Nigerian people move like defeated people. We move like a defeated people. Shoulders crouched, head down, you know, only in the front of other poor people or other oppressed people, everybody with a shine eye, you know. Where they shoot this film, they shoot the film for one ghetto. As they shoot the film for the ghetto, and because I go there by myself every day, no bodyguard. Now, one of the boys for the ghetto called, they asked me, say, why are they come for the ghetto without bodyguard and things like that? Say, normally, you're supposed to get bodyguard now. Say, anything if it happen, no. I look at, say, nothing if it happen. Say, because I don't be victim. You see, but I don't talk like that. People love you, you know that time. People love you, but anything can happen. I tell them, I say, oh, but forget, nothing if it happen. You see, well, I say, because Nigerians are cowards. Say me, I know say Nigerians, they be coward. You know, so except saying a hit, deliberate hit, won't happen to me. Say they send somebody come kill me or send people to come. Say their mission there, that to come beat me. Nothing won't happen to me for anywhere where I go. I say, yes, I understand. Say, Nigerians are, you know, they, as we talk, dangerous people. But I know they see them. Because Nigeria is dangerous, and police not going to beat us, really, they beat us for streets. I mean, not going to oppress boys, really, they oppress boys for streets. If Nigeria is dangerous, I mean, men not going to beat that actor where they beat yesterday, the way they beat her for streets like that. Because they say, if Nigeria is dangerous, they go attack those soldiers immediately. If Nigeria is dangerous, no police go fit they do anyhow. Police go they behave well because they don't say, oh, we're a dangerous place. So other than that, me understand that Nigerian people don't really get the organization. And now for me, I feel so we need to change. And now the work I've worked towards. Make Nigerian people begin to organize themselves and begin to grab power, you know, to find power. You know. Nigerian people are not interested in power. They are interested in money. You know, that for me is the blame. And the reason why is because now so they don't program us. So you need to deprogram yourself. Many people don't want to deprogram themselves. Many people want to continue to believe in that fact. Say money is everything. You understand? So that is the blame of the people. That is the blame of the people, you know, and we must fix that. We must, we the people, we get the ability to. And it will be a great disservice to the people if I talk to her and not make this point. See, the also the main reason why the people believe in money and why the people they fear to organize now because of the billions of dollars invested in the industries of distraction. The rich people of Nigeria spend billions of dollars to distract the people of Nigeria from their true purpose. You know, we go need make Nigerians understand that aspect too. You know, so when we apportion this blame that Nigerian people are doing this, are doing that, Nigerian people are also under that psychological attack. And if we go blame the people for the problem of Nigeria, say, oh, the people know they engage politically as they should, and we refuse to acknowledge, you understand, say Nigerian people are also under psychological attack, then we are not being what? We are not being honest. Because to be honest, we must engage both sides. Okay, so why Nigerian people don't take their matter serious? Why Nigerian people don't they take their reality, what did they see, serious? You understand? Then we understand that many of the reasons are because of this investment in distraction. You know, so the people are also under psychological attack. We must acknowledge and admit that fact. You know, but also many people are willfully, you know, victims of this. Anyway, we will not go deeply into that, but that will be the only topic. Secondly, now among the people are the upper middle classes. You know, the upper middle class, for me, their blame is that the profession is which I always talk always about them is that the professionals of Nigeria are completely invested in the, how would I put it? They are completely invested in the status quo. They are completely what? They are completely invested in the status quo. Many of them, now the 3% to this 6% of Nigerians, you know, this part of the people, when the degree stay for hold up. When the woman was caught corner. So when they make camp, you say they immediately go get carry police, we get siren. They go immediately go carry police, we get siren. To be like the oppressor. You know, be public servants. You know, be anything. You know, they serve this country. You just get money. Next thing, you don't buy jeep, put three police inside, put siren on top. You go, they come for road, they blow siren, make we come on by force. See, so among the people now, you must understand, say the professionals, now they bring the majority of the blame. I will put the majority of the blame of Nigeria, say the professionals, you know, they take 15%, you know. 15% of the blame is on the people. You understand? The complete 15% out of the 100% problem we will get, 15% now on the people. Now, out of these people, 15%, the 100%, you know, of the people problem, which is 15% of the major problem, the professionals carry 13.5. The upper middle classes, you know, and the professionals together, 13.5. 13.5. Why 13.5? I don't talk about many times. Because the people that work in all these companies and our civil, you know, let's start from the civil servants. You know, how can the ministries in Nigeria be as corrupt as they are without the help of the Nigerian civil servants? My brothers and sisters, anybody who don't engage Nigerian civil service bureaucracy will tell you. Sometimes the money they demand pass the official fee where you go pay to the government. And they go tell you, I said, not be only them, the president will collect, the governor will collect, the grant will give you. If you go look their banks, same thing they do there. Laundering money, everybody keep quiet. Pim, since we don't date for Nigeria, you don't yet say whistleblower from bank, come tell us before how they take London, how Nigeria money take they leave Nigeria without the help of Nigerian banks. Nobody can tell me. So the professionals, yes, if Nigerian people get problems, even they keep, we know they engage the system. Now let's look at the doctors of Nigeria. For my show yesterday, I went in on it really. The doctors, Abi, we're all Nigerians together now, Abi. See, what would they see what they do here? If you don't get money, doctor no will treat you. So the issue of our own doctors for Nigeria, nobody even say they won't make Nigeria be a healthy nation. You understand? Doctor degree for them is a way to make money. That's why somebody will get engineering degree, go abandon the engineering degree and be content with being a tailor because he's making money. Now, I don't know if any Nigerian big tailor get engineering degree. So this is my example. Congo Salah, I had to talk to. I beg you, this is just random. Imagine an engineer, you get engineering degree and you are happy with being a tailor. It shows, say, you know, you are really just about, you don't believe, you know, the professionals of Nigeria, they believe that money story pass. Because imagine somebody that's supposed to be building bridges. Bridges look at the fascinator, say, wow, who construct this bridge? People supposed to construct buildings, they construct highways across our country, they construct ultra-modern railroads and designing trains and building cars and doing all these great things. They do trouser and proud of sewing trouser. They go, I mean, you were supposed to make bridge. You build a badger and you'll be proud. You say because the country don't give you the chance. So because the country don't give you the chance, now me say you are no longer going to be this great thing. You rather sew trouser instead of you to fight to be what you're supposed to be. Then, to show you how it is all about money, if it not happen for them for Nigeria, they'll leave Nigeria, travel abroad. They'll be nurse, some Nigerians nurse, they'll be nurse for 25 years. But if they come back to Nigeria, should they go open a school to teach people how to be nurse? No. Should they go for teaching hospital to teach people how to be nurse? No. Should they go open pharmacy to? No. Except they begin to do government contract, nobody wants to engage. So, among the people, the professionals, me, I know, say, and I didn't get the power, and I didn't talk out. Imagine if Nigerian professionals went on strike for just 2 days. Just say, you know what? We had men crisis, Boko Haram, but we don't want to know who cause them. We don't want to know what happened. All this is our garden. We won't first give them a 2 days warning strike. Say, when I first receive these 2 days, first give them 2 days strike, everybody's there for us. Then, after the 2 days strike, Nigerian professionals tell our government again, say, come. We don't say, we don't strike 2 days now. We won't give them 4 months to solve all these problems where they happen for this this violent problem, kidnapping. We won't make 4 months, Boko Haram, 4 months now we give them. If we don't stop in 4 months, we are going on indefinite strike. Understand Nigeria no go, they no go do something. They go do something now. But can they ever? Never. Instead, you go there and talk to Nigerian youth. Youth, what is now make as in power is necessary to bring change. The people with power among the people, you know, the ones who get power among the people are the professionals. Because now get leverage against this our elites. This una leverage. Because they make their machines, they turn. Without you people, their machines cannot turn. none of them they join together to talk about children dying in hospital, ASU strike. Let's say all these things don't concern them because they collect one kind salary. This salary now is not even enough. Oh. You understand? You know, say this salary is even enough. It's not enough. The guys, they do mago-mago for the company, and your guy know. Because he won't make you corrupt your soul, make you corrupt your spirit. The more your spirit corrupt, the more you and you know, are becoming alike, the more they are promoting you more. Yes, that's what's going on. We all know what's going on. Because of us don't act like we don't know what they go on among we, the people. So this is what is going on with among we. There's no class solidarity. We don't get work. We don't get small change. We, the people, we don't get solidarity with the poor. We laugh at them. We make fun of them. We only want to use them. We only want to use them. May they come clean our compound, wash our car. Come, they tell us how we will help them pay their students' school fees. So the video tells you, you'll be a good man. Instead of you to pay your tax and make sure the government use that tax to make the public schools good. But we, the people, this is our problem. Our ability to have class solidarity, that solidarity, that word. Instead, that the sponsor things where they divide us the more, they have poor people, they tell poor people saying that because God don't like them, that's why they're poor. And things like that. They talk say rich people are rich because God bless them. They have anointing of God on them. Just pray for your own to come. All those kind of stupid things we tell the people in the media. Imagine what we do in the media. Now we dead there now. I mean, the politicians, they can't run media by themselves. Now politicians, they can't run them. No. Now we dead there now. The media will regurgitate the nonsense. Nobody in this country is caring about nation building. I mean, not be nation building, we suppose they do for here, all of us. Not be nation building. We're supposed to be building this nation. If you and I did like this, would they ask, what would they do if we're not building our nation? What are we doing? Share our nation, they okay, ni? Are we because we they plan to go America, we they all plan to go Switzerland, we they plan to go Dubai, we they plan to Jah. So as all those places don't day as the day, now we won't go beat and day. We don't feel believe we feel build our own, even find past that one. We the people, we they support our own demise, we support our own destruction. We they work for the people, we don't even for once look back, look side, we just look front, look front. They want to chase. I mean, so for me, that's our blame, but it's still 15% of the blame. Because for all these things that happen, somebody must they drop the waiting, must they drop the bar. The Nigerian elites coming in strong with 35% of Africa's problem, ready to drop bar on negative things all the time, ready to drop bar to finance anything to keep you down. After their ancestors have done slavery work. I mean, just imagine a nation that where their our elite ancestors were selling us. Oh, ha! See, me, I tell you something. You know. Slavery was normal, yes. It happened everywhere in this world, yes. Humanity or everybody went through slavery at some point. But you see, what Europeans and Arabs did in Africa was different. They always talk, say, hey, Africa has been getting slaves. But you see, African slavery and war slavery that time just means saying you are second class citizen to a certain extent. Because slaves, they born slaves. So if they feel they yab you, in those days, say your father is a slave. But you, when they don't born, you don't be slave. Oyibo slavery turned black skin to stamp of slavery. Don't you understand? So whether they born you, you are a slave until white man claims say you are not. So these people wait, allow this kind of system to happen to us, to taint our skin. Our skin. Now that this color be the color where they rule the world. These people will preside over turning ruling color to slavery color. Imagine their descendants. Just imagine these kind of people. And we go sit down for their middle. They allow them to talk, allow them to rule, they do big man, they hate them. You know, I mean, do you understand your reality? Is it important to you at all? You know? Because I don't understand. I mean, how many African people life must people destroy before you take them serious, you know? Because I always wonder, you know, these things. Even our cancel culture, you know, even me, if you all remember, they don't try to cancel me. This year alone, 2 times, they've led cancel campaign against me. But Ekonlomo, it's impossible. My followership are revolutionaries. They don't care about your material feelings. They know why they are following me. They are not following me because I've turned my life to entertainment. My life not be entertainment. I give people my music, that my music will entertain them. I share knowledge with Una. That one they attract Una to me. So okay, we share ideas, we share knowledge, everybody they talk when they want to talk. You don't understand? But say I go turn my life to entertainment. It's impossible. I can't use my life to entertain anybody. You know? Anyway. So all these things when they happen for our country, before any small thing, you cancel this one, you cancel that one. Waiting these evil people for this country go do before I cancel them. Nigerian professionals. What do they have to do before you cancel them? If you truly believe in cancel culture. Peter Obi name come out for Pandora paper. Say this country will be like this. So some people get money for this country, they keep her outside. That must take him out, talk him old house. Say 60% of your own family wealth is outside Nigeria, kept in foreign currency. So whose responsibility is it? Now, why I talk about the Nigerian elite this way, Una must understand. When I talk about Nigerian elite this way, listen to me, it's because they have power. Power. You and I will not fit command navy, will not fit command army, will not fit command police, will not fit do all these things. We don't have billions of dollars now. But we get people where get this kind of bar. We get people where get this kind of power, where they talk to men, where they control things. So with this kind of power now, you don't need mass movement to. You don't need organization of thousands of people to make progress happen. Five of Una fit sit down for table or more, we won't end hunger for Nigeria. What did they happen? Let's flex. Let's flex this our bar. Let's flex this bar on these Nigerian people. Let's feed this nation. They can do it though. But they refuse. Do you know how easy it is for 5 men to sit down and agree something? It's definitely easier than hundreds of thousands of people sitting down to agree. Definitely, Abi. So my own indictment of these people is from their lackadaisical attitude to the situation of the country. But their own personal life is moving at a breakneck speed. Everything they are giving themselves fast. No, private jet, building for everywhere in the world, no, all the finest cars, all the finest girls, everything that they need for their life to be the best. The other one is Abi Flex. Abi Sheni, ordinary Indomie, where they give Nigeria, they carry and hide. You see, when people make this kind of thing, they can't, but they are scared of the government. It always irritates me. You know, who is scared of which government? How can you say the Nigerian below, which government are they scared of? Their friends? They are guys. Why can't they be scared? In which world are they scared of the government? It's impossible they are not scared of the government. The kind of things that they do, the laws that they break, who they hold them responsible for the laws when they break every day for this country. Go to the Niger Delta. Gas flaring is illegal in... Gas flaring is illegal in the whole world in petrochemical manufacturing. You cannot flare gas. Any gas company or oil company that does it is fined heavily. They must pay. In Nigeria, go to the Middle East, Niger Delta. Here in Nigeria, 24 hours a day, they need to flare gas when nothing they happen. You say they are afraid of government. Afraid of which government? Government, where did they pay, where did they donate 25 billion? 25 billion naira to for election, end of the year. Nobody's afraid of any government. They are the government. Them and government are one. Yes, what's the difference between any businessman in Nigeria and politicians? They are one. They are working together. They are shareholders in each other's businesses. They are shareholders in each other's businesses. They share business interests. They play in the same business field. I beg. We know what's going on here. So these men have the power, the resources, the wealth. But they will rather fund things that are degrading the country. Boko Haram go start. No. Boko Haram don't get the best weapon. No, Boko Haram don't get the best move to the workout, to do everything. The best training. But you cannot put the best library in children's school. Me, I know for a fact that it is cheaper to build libraries in schools than to arm militias. Yet, they are arming militias, left, right, and center. Schools dilapidated. Go to the island. They are building houses that people are not living inside. Expensive houses that people cannot afford to live inside. It's just empty, just dated. Nobody is building public housing. Look at children all over the road in Nigeria. Look at African children. So you now have to ask yourself, now this brings me to our leaders, because they are the same with these people I'm talking about. These people, you now have to wonder that what is their reason for ruling this country? What are you doing? You are you're a political leader in a country, and you are watching poverty multiply and multiply and multiply, and you are protecting individual properties that were still gotten from the suffering of those poor people. I mean, what is your own goal here? What is your job? Because there's a difference that you're trying to develop a nation, and there's a difference that you're just trying to stop people from touching what is their own. Because this is what I'm seeing now. I think our government in Africa, all our politicians, their duty is to stop Africans from acquiring wealth. Yes. Their duty is to make sure that they stop Africans from accessing their resources. This is all I see our governments doing. That their duty is to make sure that foreign companies have more access to Nigerian resources than the Nigerian people. That's all I see here. Where is the... What are they doing for Nigeria? These people that call themselves government, they've been in power since 1960. They have not solved one problem in this country. They have created more problems that even problems we did not have before, they have created it. Yes. Cultism in university. Eh? Nigeria did not have that one before 1960 now. We didn't have that before 1960. This is new problem that they've caused. Homelessness. I keep telling people, if you are in my generation, if you are in your 40s, if you are about to, if you are in your late 30s, your grandfather is a homeowner. There was no homelessness in Africa. They brought homelessness. What are you doing to end up? Nothing. Homeless, housing, education, water, light, transportation, sanitation, healthcare. All the problems still there. They are adding more. They are, now we have headsmen and farmer clashes. We have kidnapping problem. No problem we will not get. No problem where we not get. These men have refused to create new institutions. How can you be leaders of a nation and you have not come up with institutions that are specific to that nation, that are specific to our problems? All the institutions what we get for Nigeria now, foreign institutions, where they teach us. Our educational institution is foreign, our religious institutions are foreign, the one they teach us need. We abandon all our own. Our banking institutions, financial institutions are all foreign, with foreign system, all of them. And we not say we get problem for here, we do not get for foreign land. For all those Western countries, they know they go through farmer and herder clashes. Right? They not get 300 languages for England. How many languages they get for America? Look at them, so divided already. So where we get all this diversity? Where are the institutions to manage it? Where are the institutions? You know, they no imagination. These leaders don't get imagination, my brothers and sisters. The imagination necessary to govern a nation as diverse as our own, or rather, they don't want to invest in those kind of things because their job is not to build this nation. And they tell you now, because to build the nation, they import, building the nation is important. This nation must be built, right? So, waiting anybody with power they do for this country if the person is not actively building the nation. Why are we proud of people that have billions when Africa, our country, is crumbling? Why are we proud of it? Where did that money come from? Me, I don't know. So we need to ask ourselves those questions. For me, that's not where 30%. 35% of African people come from. Nigeria problem day. Nigeria people problem, 35% of them come from this our visionless elite. This petit bourgeoisie that, you know, these people, their only ambition is to be white, to act white, to behave white, to do the things where white people they do. And knowing fully well, see, they never accomplish those things where the white bourgeoisie don't accomplish, right? They must now cover themselves with the facade of white things, white material things, white material luxury, to try in a kind of stupid, macabre, dumb way to trick the white people that they are successful. Nigerian elites, and both political and business, let me tell you now, the whites know you are not successful. Because they see your country. They can see you coming to beg for money. Money to build roads. Money to do farm. Money, they can see. So they know you are not successful. Stop buying their jets to arrive in private jets. Because you get, be yourselves. be African men building a nation. See, if you are just normally living your life, you know, yes, you have, but you are building this nation and you go to all these meetings, you take first class. Don't even take first class. Is it too small for you? You take first class, you arrive in your normal, you know, expensive clothes if you want it. Be yourself, but be building your nation. The fact that you are building your nation will give you more respect in the eyes of the world than wearing 1 million Rolex, I swear, or wearing a $10,000 suit. They will not respect you. They know you. You are nothing but a nigger to them. Even in the, if you put you, even the one, the black man that made it to the White House. Nigga, come on, guys. So you must understand our mistakes. Change your way. Build the nation. That's what. If you are developing this nation, doing what you're supposed to do, not be say you now go carry the land where be everybody land. Take and they grow food where local people not fit afford. And then the rest of the food when they grow and send them to our, just using it to enrich yourself. Crack using 74% of our land to grow cash crops so you can sell it to Oyibo and make money while your people are hungry. Come on. There's no brain in that. How can you be the elite of hungry people and you are happy? Then you are hungry, you are hungry, you are the elite of the hungry. You are the elite of the hungry. Okay, what can you be? So that's why your elitism is hyperbolical. It's like you are a poor bourgeois. Poor bourgeoisie. How can that make sense? Come on, man. Come on. And let me tell you, no matter how you try and make this money, you know, and try and act sophisticated, and they give you percentage in their companies, and they take you and... until you build Africa, they can never respect you. You know, until they have more say, because they know they even have more say than you in your country. You know, hold on, let me ask her, I'll call her back. You know, so yeah, 35% of our blame is definitely in the hands of those with power, but do nothing with it. Cannot blame the Nigerian people, we have no power, we are trying. Then the ones of us we get power, they use the power to make the elite power stronger. So that's where the problem of the people they in the hands of the professionals that they carry all our problem, our professionals. Then our elites, their lack of imagination, their lack of Pan-Africanist spirit, their inferiority complex from their ancestors, you know, because those Oyibos really mesmerize them, gone, you know, and they're not gonna tell you the true history. Say even to now we the people pursue Oyibo, not be Azikiwe and Awolowo and Balewa and Sadauna as they will tell you now. No. Even though Azikiwe gone, he betrayed Zikis movement, the Aba women's riot, the Abeokuta women's riot, the Pa Imodu led union. Go and listen. Investigate about Pa Imodu, the man that created the Nigerian Labour Union, whether they turned to Labour Congress and bastardized today. That's no longer for the people. 3 million Nigerian workers went on strike. The colonial government was brought to a standstill. These were the people that fought for Nigeria to be free. Then quickly, all these elites, these children of chiefs, children of slave traders, children of collaborators, businessmen working for all of them quickly go join the movement because they saw that they could use the people to gain more from their masters. Say, see the people, but gotta be also we loyal, but these are our people, you know, they are tired of seeing you here. Just give us the thing. Make we, if they see us, they no go, they go to say that don't go. So they use the people, they reach there and continue the work of their masters. So now these people that they teach us freedom in the wrong way, we will be Africans. We say freedom for us is discipline. You say easy to discipline, to get self-discipline. These our elite, they lack discipline now. That's why they cannot do without stealing people's things. Steal something, you steal past the one way you need. So trust me. And I always tell my followers, not be my follower, my people, my fellow revolutionaries. I don't get for who's not be follower. All these things. This world they don't put for people's mouths. They know what they are trying to do, try to put their oppressor spirit inside you. You don't understand? You begin call people who like you, followers. I don't understand. My co-revolutionaries, you know, my people. Now be my people, I don't know followers who all this name they give you now. You know? So these people, we must be they see through their bullshit. I must begin to act accordingly. You understand? So now I don't account for about 50% of Nigeria problem. Now, the remaining 50%, definitely in the hands of the West. Definitely in the hands of the Arabs, and now the Chinese are joining in. Yes, because I say who anybody where they fund the nonsense is the one we have to blame. Who is funding this nonsense? IMF loan, World Bank loan. Say IMF and World Bank decrease me. Say IMF and World Bank, say they're blind me. Say IMF and World Bank. They don't they see say Mona no so that baby, you don't they go?
No.
Okay. Say IMF and World Bank. No, they see say all the things where they say they borrow people money. You don't understand? Say they don't take the thing, do the money, do the thing. And they give you money for light since 1970 something. Yet light no day. And I say they give you more money for the light. You know me say either me are the idiot or me and you know say we play game. Say we don't want to do light. IMF and World Bank now give Nigeria structural adjustment program. Now they tell Nigerian government say it is wrong to invest in the people of this country. Say, maybe they let the rich people take over everything. Say, if the rich people take over everything, they go spread harm. Oga Edin, I yet today they talk to. Enyashoni, Mameni, Efimile. Ah, Abio Sheni, now one for them. Now, so they go say, tell Sheni, say, for say, they see me with babe for James in the fair event. Say, they kiss the babe for public. I don't even say. Ah, now Sheni wrong message me, say, ah, they don't see you for. They don't see you for JMC event, oh. May you call, though. May they don't go take your picture. I say, Shaggy, now my madam, I day with, oh. Now my madam, I day with, oh.
They are calling for you. Watch your back. Is it 1 day or 2 days?
My brother, I know it's you. Eddie, I don't say you're a joke. But at the same time, you know, if you know the joke, I mean, Eddie, look up, come at me. Yet today, that I didn't talk to. The time is 13:04 where that thing happened. So, you can ask my wife. It wasn't at my around at 4 minutes past one. You know? So, yeah. You find that the West are also very willing to fund the nonsense of our politicians. You understand? So, those ones, they collect billions of dollars. You know, they share millions to their minions here to keep the game going. Because my own number one blame, they say, out of all this is what they talk now. Nobody say Africans never work hard still to get them right. We got it right many times in Africa. We got it right with Thomas Sankara. What happened to Thomas Sankara? Blaise Campore shoot him for back on CIA planning and order. What happened to Lumumba when we get him right for Congo? They carry Lumumba Belgian troops arrest Lumumba, go hand him over to their boy, Mobutu Sese Seko, make him kill him. What happened to Nkrumah government? Yeah, we've gotten it right, man. What happened to Sokoto Ture government? What happened to Abdel Nasser government for Egypt? So we as African people, we've gotten it right many times. And we get people where they make us see the open the wrong piece, wrong piece. Let the dog out. Close the front door, make it not jump outside. Then I know this. So yeah. So we don't get them many times right now. And suddenly people decided to kill those leaders or sabotage those leaders. Che, you know the letter already because she's on heat. We go there, then we do anything, no worry. My dog, Che, we have a daughter in my house, Nina. And Nina is on heat. Che, no one let the dog rest. Eh? Your own daughter. I don't even understand, where? Oba Sanjo too. Now, so you go, am I daughter-in-law that time? Where you can carry and go court. So, who knows? Who knows what is going on in this country? It's a small step from daughter-in-law to daughter. Trust me. It's a small step. I don't even want to know anything. Can I marry your daughter-in-law? Ah! I will let it degenerate. And they'll call they talk only talk, Jesus Christ. All this is they fear me for Africa. Because this is they fear me for Africa. They fear me. And they fear. But they fear, bro. So now, we need to ask the question, definitely say, if the Europeans are funding the misleaders of Africa, then they are the reason why the misleaders of Africa are misleading Africa. We cannot say Westerners have handed over when they still own 74% of most African economies. Do you understand what I'm saying? What do you mean you are no longer involved in our country, we are independent, when you still have 74% of our economy in your control? What will happen today if Nigeria says we are no longer doing listening to IMF? What will happen today if Nigeria refuses to sell its oil in the international market according to the prices that OPEC and America are setting? What will happen to Nigeria? Would they allow, would they agree? Or what happened in Iraq, what happened in Libya, would need to happen here? That's why when Nigeria, they talk about, oh, Fulani people are trying to Islamize Nigeria. I feel heartbroken. I feel like we know that our reality is blind to us. You have been Islamized long time ago. You have been Europeanized long time ago. They cannot come and re-Islamize or Europeanize you. My brothers and sisters, and they call Nigerian money here. Eh? Oh, now 1,000 I get, now 500 a day. You know, no, we can say there, yes, yeah. Look, is it not Arabic on your money? Is this not Arabic on your money? Do you know what it means that you have Arab language on your money? It means you have been Islamized. And then this money is not tied to what? This money is tied to the dollar. The American dollar determines the value of this money. Which now means what? You have been westernized. In your money. Just hold your money and your reality is there in your face. You are Arabized, Islamized, whatever you want to call it. And then the fact that your money value is tied. Because that's how Western imperialism is strong, so it can be subtle. They don't need to write, the queen, we love the queen, or something. But it's in dollar, you calculate it. Again, you are westernized. Your duty is to remove these chains, but you don't want to remove the chains. Imagine, are they for this same Nigeria? Nigerian Christians are complaining about underage marriage of Muslims. that Islam, like as if Catholic priests are not under, I want to talk, what Catholic underage or Catholic priests, they are under, this dog will kill me. I'm coming. Let me go.
The German viewer.
Yeah, Nina, inside. Inside, Nina. Tell the bridge up again. Surely indeed don't come out.
He don't tell you anything in one chop. And he give him an artie.
Nah, no way. And this is the girl's first hit. She can't even meet. May leave the poor dog. Eh? Christians go to talk about Muslim underage marriage as if at least the Muslims have the self-respect to marry their victim. You know, at least, so I mean, they marry the victim and, you know, at least they take responsibility of their victim. Eh? Okay, forget Catholic priests. In this, our churches, how many kids don't come and say, Pastor, they fuck young girls? How did that? My dog's breed is an American bully. They are called American bullies. My own is an XL. They come in different sizes, but mine is the biggest ones. Eh? I don't know if you people follow Russell Brand. Russell Brand is a actor and political activist. Correct guy, or white guy, you know. Russell Brand gets TV show for Instagram too, and on YouTube he gets one podcast. But if you go in page, he still they talk about how they ask Bill Gates, say why he and Jeffrey Epstein be friend. Bill Gates don't feel answer. Bill Gates. Jeffrey Epstein, I hope you people know who Jeffrey Epstein is. Jeffrey Epstein is the pedophile guy with a catch. Way before he go give his statement, they don't go kill her inside jail last year. You know? My dog is westernized. Which kind of dog the one I get now? I get bingo. I don't get bingo now because all those bingo dogs, you don't really need to take care of them. They take care of themselves already. So now dogs really taking care of. Now you go buy that. When I won't take all you these people for my, this is that they crazy, I swear. The gold that they smoke, they watch this thing, they worry you now. So Jeffrey Epstein is a pedophile. They offer before if he call all the fellow pedophile name for Jay. And he and Bill Gates, he and Bill Gates, they do dinners together. They meet. Say, oh God, Bill Gates, why are you friends with this guy? You know if he answer well. And if you look, Bill Gates' wife just leave her for old age. Not because the woman won't be a fine boyfriend at this age. Bill Gates is the richest man in the world. Apparently, he loved the world so much. You know, he's even investing from his heart for us to have vaccine so we don't die. You understand this? Why your wife leave her at this old age? Things are coming out.
You are correct.
So when Christians go, they actually, you are all twisted together. Don't be yabbing the Muslims as if Catholic priests are not busy defiling young boys. I can't even say it. It's so heinous. This crime is so heinous. I mean, the fact that Catholicism has not been banned outrightly, just by this revelation in France alone now, over 216,000 children, the ones that happened to one time, if you now add the ones that it happened to continuously to the list, is over 330,000 people abused. This institution is still allowed to continue to keep going, to keep going. Imagine if they hear, say, only two members of Egypt 80 band molest two boys. Imagine what's going to happen. Imagine what's going to happen. Shaka wants to come and help me yab them. Okay. My G, welcome. I'll always bring you in, my G. Come on, let's do this. We have 30 that we can kill. Let's kill them for like 13 minutes, bro. I don't bring Shaka already. Shaka. That's my man from in Goma. How is Congo, man?
I'm in the street. Look, this whole place is a fucking UN base. Every vehicle is some charity. Every vehicle is some fucking UN.
It's UN. I see.
Hey, they be everywhere.
We've been recolonized, brother.
They're everywhere. How are you?
I'm good, man. I'm good.
Let me turn this around. How are you?
I'm good. I was just about to wrap up this live. You know.
You good? What are we talking about today? What corruption have you been talking about in your life?
Look, today we're just deciding really who is to blame with what's going on in Africa, because certain people say it is African people's fault because we are independent and we are the ones not using our independence properly. You know. So I'm analyzing, you know, everybody's blame, and I'm like, everybody's right. There's enough blame to go around in this case.
Wait, who's the most to blame, though? I'm saying I blame white people, Arabs,
oh,
and Chinese.
Please. Give me your perspective, please.
Okay, I believe this. I believe, you know, corruption and elite.
So Shaka, we can't see your face, man. It's like we're talking to your sweater.
Sorry. I believe that corruption and elitism exists everywhere in the world and has existed for a long time. Hey, yes. Look at this guy. He's got a sofa on his thing. I believe that elitism and corruption has existed for a long time. But this whole narrative, this bullshit narrative, Africans sold Africans first, is almost Europeans use it as an excuse. Colonizers use it as an excuse for the horrendous acts they then committed and continue to commit. African leaders can't be corrupt on their own. They're corrupt with Europeans, they're corrupt with Chinese, they're corrupt with Indians.
That's the point I was trying to make now. That imagine African leaders without European banks. They can steal all the money they want in the world, but they will have to keep it here and use it here.
Right. There's no bailout for them.
African leaders without European banks will not be able to be anti-African. And that for me is really the problem I have with them. My problem with them is not that they are corrupt or they are evil or they are bad. It's that they are anti-African. You know, because you can be bad for Africa. And I would like you, if you are doing bad things so that Africa can progress, you know. Hey!
But the thing is this, is that now these fake black bourgeoisie, these African bourgeoisie class have somebody to be corrupt with. They continue to, with nepotism, cronyism, and corruption, they continue to perpetuate the cycle of corruption. And I was speaking to my friend about it yesterday, and we were saying, like, where's the next Lumumba? Where's the next Sankara?
Hang on.
Wait, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
You can hear me. Yeah, we were saying, where's the Lumumba? Where's the next Sankara? Where is this thing making noise like this? Yeah, where are the next revolutionary leaders? That's what I'm looking for is little we need leaders. We need leaders that are uncorruptible, and we need them to organize people. We need leaders and we need them to organize people. And once that begins to happen, in terms of, because the thing is like the way that myself has been inspired by, you know, Malcolm X and Marcus Garvey and Kwame Nkrumah and all these people, they've created a culture that I now exist within. Whereas there's some places where there's so much corruption, there's no culture of respect, there's no culture of the only culture they have is the culture of
mass accumulation,
and that's the problem,
right?
One of the bigger problems. And so I feel like leading by example and creating examples and then creating economies where we can exist. We don't need, like I was explaining to my friends today, every single mineral apart from two minerals known to man are here in Congo. So Congolese people are sitting here thinking, oh well, when the Oyimbe come here, they're bringing the money. It's like, no, the only reason that they're coming here is because the money's already here. That's the reason why they're coming here.
Exactly.
So the people here need to realize that actually they need to stop fucking with them and stop importing everything and start cycling the money, and then they won't need anything. Never. They will never need anything. We just need manufacturing here in Africa. That's what we need. That's the main thing we need, is manufacturing here. We don't need anything else because we have everything. We have the labor, we have the resources. We just need manufacturing.
Exactly. And for manufacturing to happen, this our elites need to prefer building a factory to owning a private jet. You understand?
Yeah,
you need to prefer paying your employees.
Look at these fucking,
well.
Look at this shit.
Everywhere.
It's a bunch of fucking Indians. Why are they all fucking here?
And why is Africa looking so the same with so much suffering everywhere, you know? Like, aren't we tired of this shit?
Right. Like,
I thought you were in Ibadan in Lagos. I could have been in some area. Exactly. I mean, you could be somewhere in Lagos right now.
Right. Or I could be somewhere in Burkina Faso. Or I could be somewhere in Senegal. It's all the same shit.
It's like they have a blueprint design, you know, this look. They have this look for us, you know, this approved African look.
Right. It's all the same bullshit. And it's like, for me, I've got to ask you, the same people who come in here from India, from Turkey, from Bangladesh, from fucking Kenya, they have the one here, the minerals.
I didn't hear the last.
You know that. They have their own countries. They have their own problems in their own country. So why are they here in Congo? They're here for the minerals. That's it. They don't care about the people here.
I don't see why America doesn't need United Nations troops right now. Their capital building was just attacked by their own citizens. You understand? They need the United Nations. They need a peacekeeping force. You know? Some of these people in Congo need to go to the United States and at least protect their politicians from the mob.
Yeah, but that is like, because the United States is the American army.
Of course.
The same show.
So anyway, I'm glad that you joined the live, bro. I gotta run because I have a concert today.
Yeah, man. Do your thing.
Thanks for joining my live, man. Let's plan more on your page. You know,
please,
I can only
be brought live. I can't go live, they banned me.
Okay, you promised me some CMOS, bro. Listen,
I can send you some CMOS.
You promised me CMOS. I'm still looking in the mail. I'm waiting for this package, man. Hey,
you never sent me no address.
I did, man. I did on your Instagram, brother.
I said it again. On Instagram, send me your number so that because on Instagram I get you send it on a WhatsApp or on an iMessage, I'll get it.
Okay, I will.
But yeah, pour libation for the people of Congo today when you do your show.
I definitely will. I pour for all African people every day, but I will pour a special one in your name today.
Blessed love. 444.
Thank you, brother. Yeah, everybody, you know, So that for me, you know, so when they say white people no longer have, we are independent, yes, I agree, but it's in your banks, they are hiding all the money. You are the one that give the people that committed Rwanda genocide. What do they call it? When you go to somebody's country, asylum. People will destroy Africa, run to Europe. You give them asylum. You know? So, I mean, look at Libya. Whatever Gaddafi has done in Libya to destroy Libya is not up to what Obama did there in 1 year. Abi, Dezani. We are looking for Dezani to come and answer case in Nigeria. Nigeria, one of the ever in this world. Nigeria, one of the ever in this world prosecutes criminal. We can't catch criminal today now. What do you want to do? We want to carry him. Boom. Una hide them for UK. Una hide them for UK finish, we can't prosecute the woman. Somebody commit crime in Nigeria, you're hiding him in UK. Hiding her in UK. We cannot prosecute her. Now, person can't commit crime for Nigeria. Una go say we send the person to Una. Say the person he sell drugs for our country. The person will steal all our money, will lead to the death of millions of children, millions of women, millions of men. Destroying our country, that one I go hide for their on our country. See, na Africans they corrupt. If Africans are corrupt, what kind of country hides somebody from that they want to try for corruption? Anyway, so that for me, 50% to the Europeans, 35% to the African elites, 15% to the African people. Let us all get our acts together and stop deceiving ourselves, you know. Thank you very much.